The United Nations is launching its biggest effort thus far to bring aid to the millions of struggling people due to the Syrian civil war. The UN says the situation there is going down quickly, and they need over $5 billion to fund operations through the end of 2013. The UN estimates nearly 7 million civilians inside Syria need help, as well as more than 1.5 million that have fled to neighboring countries. Funding for food and medicine remains a top priority for the UN.
At the same time, you don't
know the situation
claim that
in Syria.
Guilty.
We turn now to senior international correspondent George Thomas. George, the UN is launching this effort to bring aid to civilians in Syria. What are the conditions like for those in Syria who have not yet fled?
Yeah, it's horrible. I mean, the reality is that you have a situation where half the country is suffering. You've got immense destruction. You go to Homs, Latakia, the suburbs of Damascus. Clearly, there are homes that have been completely obliterated. Hundreds of thousands of people have now moved to neighboring countries, Iraq, Jordan, Lebanon. So the situation is spilling beyond the borders of Syria because, A, the artillery, the fighting is so intense, they have nowhere to go, and so the aid is desperately needed.
Syrian's opposition group is saying now that the involvement of Hezbollah is turning this into a sectarian conflict between Sunnis and Shiites. Mm-hmm. What does that mean for the war?
Yeah, people need to understand, we're talking about terrorists designated by the United States fighting another terrorist group. So you have Hezbollah and on one side, Hezbollah and Iran versus Al-Qaeda. So you have two terrorist organizations fighting each other for the control of Syria. So it's a dicey mix. And so the question is, who does the United States support?
Let's talk now about Israel. Yesterday, they moved tanks along the border in the Golan Heights. Yeah. Should Israelis be concerned that the war is actually going to cross the border into their country?
They have all reasons to be concerned because the Austrians, they had about 390 UN peacekeepers in this buffer zone, keeping the Syrians on one side, the Israelis on the other side. The Austrians said, we're out of here. And so they are leaving the Golan Heights because the fighting is getting closer and closer to the Israeli border. The Israelis are moving tanks to the area to say, listen, we are making a buffer zone. Don't think about allowing this to spill into our land. We will have to respond. And so obviously that's a big concern.
George, is there any end in sight or are things going to have to get worse before they get better?
No, I think it's a huge dilemma because partly because the United States just does not know how to deal with the situation. You know, if you look at historical aspect, the United States in the Middle East situation has always inserted itself somehow into the region. Today, it's taken a hands-off approach because they don't know exactly what to do. Should we arm, like I said, the free Syrian rebels? Should we arm, who do we support in this fight? And so that's the challenge. And I think, all options are not good, but trying to figure out how to bring this to a peaceful resolution just doesn't seem to be something we can happen very soon.
All right, George Thomas, our senior international correspondent. Thanks, George.
You're welcome.
Wendy.